And folks, coming up next, Mighty Mo and Raul Catinas. Welcome back to Seoul, Korea. We are ready for Mighty Mo versus Raul Catinas. Let's take a look at the pre-fight hype. We've already seen one Romanian through in thumping fashion tonight in Daniel Gita. Can Raul Catinas make it 2-0 for Team Romania here tonight? The little anvil from Romania. This guy hits you. He hits you hard. Only three fights in K1, two vicious knockouts. Last time out, he knocked out Carter Williams in Bucharest in the opening round. He also has a vicious knockout over Przemyslaw Minkinia in Lodz, Poland. The little fireball that is Catinas. Mighty Mo comes in on only 3 days' notice. A last-minute replacement for Andrei Arlovsky, who was meant to be here in the final 16. Look at Mo. Mike, you're telling me he has lost 50 pounds.
Mighty Mo is down to 270 pounds, which he hasn't seen since he lost his Mighty. So now he's got the Mighty back. He's back to being Mighty Mo.
Is he going to put the Mighty back into Mighty Mo? Mighty Mo Saliga.
And he's back with his original trainer, Eddie Mills, who made him Mighty Mo to start with. So we'll see what happens here.
And it's been a long time between drinks for Mighty Mo. You remember his outing to the K1 Grand Prix. when he suffered one of the greatest highlight reel knockouts in K1 history against a little Thai bloke named Cal Clay, who weighed only 78 kilos.
Right? The flying knee? That was ridiculous.
The flying round kick.
Oh, okay, I'm sorry.
It was crazy. If you haven't seen it, YouTube it. Cal Clay versus Mighty Mo. And brother,
look at Mo.
Shape here on Mo.
Look at Mo. He wasn't lying. He got the mighty shape for sure. We'll see if he's got the mighty power and the mighty...
You know, boys, all three of us were in Bucharest. We saw these two men fight over there in Romania in May. This one is not going to go the distance.
No, two sluggers. I mean, you got two guys that like to swing for the fences and see who's going to fall first.
Catinas, 6 foot even, 243 pounds.
Well, if I was Catinas, he should stick and move.
You know, Raul Catinas is listed at 6 foot even, but you stand next to him, Mike, he's around my height. He's
yeah.
only about 5'10".
I'd say so, yeah.
He is the smallest man in the final 16 here tonight, taking on one of the heaviest.
Well, height-wise, but weight-wise, I think Gokhan Saki and probably Freddy Kameo were definitely there in the candidacy.
Final instructions from the center referee, Romania versus the US of A. 3x3, two extra rounds in case of a draw. And look at the stare down here, Mo and Catinas. On 3 days' notice, can the American Smarmo and Mighty Mo make it through to the Grand Prix? Or can Catinas make it 2-0 for Team Romania? Michael Chiavello, Mike Kogan, Sugar Ray Sefo with you ringside. We are live from Seoul, Korea. Do not blink. Do not go to the toilet. Tire not in it. You do not want to miss this one. Look for Catinas' left hook. Look for Mighty Mo's thumping overhand right.
And it's about to come.
Mo always setting for that bread and butter shot. The moneymaker. Good outside leg kick from Catinas. That could be the right idea. Tenderize the legs of Mighty Mo.
Well, that, absolutely. That's what he needs to do. To stick and move. Low kick, stick and move. Mo needs to close that gap and find that uppercut left hook and a short overhand right.
Catinas' game. He chops away. 1, 2, 3 strikes to the lead leg. The bandaged lead leg of Mighty Mo. And this is good movement so far from the Romanian, Mikey.
Yeah, and very uncharacteristic. Catinas is usually like a Mo-style fighter that'll charge forward and try to power shot you. And you're right, he's doing exactly what you said he should do. Stick and move, throw those the front kick, slow down Mo.
Exactly. Mighty Mo throwing that overhand right. Catinas returning the favor. It is all Catinas so far. But if Mo lands that right hand, don't forget in 2007 in March, he was the first man ever to knock out Hong Man Choi with an overhand right. Leg check there from Mo.
I mean, Mo is telegraphing that overhand right. You can see it coming from the bleachers.
Well, I mean, you know, he took this fight on what? 4 days, 3 days notice?
No, I don't know where you guys get your data. Took this fight on less than a day notice, 12
well,
hours.
Exactly.
I called him Tuesday and I said, you're getting on a flight in the morning.
Well, did we just see a head kick from Mighty Mo?
Mighty Mo!
I'm landing.
Woo!
It landed.
He's lost some weight in his
there goes the left hook.
That's a fight. That's
no.
a count.
No count. Only a slip as the referee. This is a good old-fashioned brawl. Catinas is not going to stand down. He wants to slug with Mo.
He does not want to do that with Mo.
That is
he
no
does
more
not
want to
do that with Mo.
This is what Catinas
oh!
does.
Here
this is what happens.
Here comes the Mo train. Here comes the Mo train.
Oh, he's on Queer Street.
Catinas, it's over.
Catinas is back in Bucharest, baby.
He does not want to do that with Mo.
Catinas is right for the picking. The Mo train is steaming into the station. Mo goes to the body. Catinas surviving. Mo curls the knuckles in. Uppercut rocks the head back. Oh, Catinas sustaining enormous punishment. Huge swelling on his forehead. Oh, Mo just teeing off at him, lining up the money shots. Final 10 seconds. Can Catinas survive? Goes to the legs. He tags Mo. He tagged Mo with the left hook. End of the round. Oh, crazy scenes here, Ray.
Wow, what can I say? I mean, he was doing so well in the first half of the fight, half of the round. He decided to be stubborn. Mighty Mo is hits like a brick wall.
Imagine, where did he get that idea? Hey, once a slugger, you're always a slugger. They all try. They know what they need to do, but they don't do it. Melvin fought Remy Boyanski. First two rounds, he was winning because he was fighting. Started to slug it out. He ended up losing.
That is true.
But the fight, the first round ended exactly how we thought this fight was going to go. Two guys just swinging for the fences. Except that front leg kick may become a factor here for Mo in the second round.
Yeah.
Because Catinas has been tenderizing
that leg. And Catinas needs to stick to that game plan. Otherwise, Mo's going to put him away.
All three judges giving it tonight to Mighty Mo in that round. He was a little slow coming out of the station, the Mo train. But once he started to line up and deep in the coals, he came through with the heavy stuff, right? Can he finish? That's the question.
Well, he'll finish if this guy, Catinas, makes it easy for him by standing in front of him and slug with him.
Oh, Catinas with a rattling left hand! He's opened up like a house of fire!
Now Catinas needs to move again.
Left hook again from Catinas. He keeps chomping away the Romanian. He's got a set of nerves on him.
Mo's got to kick that front leg too. Mo's got some pretty heavy legs there.
Catinas kicks to the lead thigh. Mo fakes off the front. Catinas slings to the legs again. He wants to take the legs, get Mo to drop his hands, then clip him over the top of the left hook. Mo catches him, Catinas on rubber legs!
Catinas to move and clear his head before he starts slugging again.
Catinas is breathing heavy, he's blowing up a storm. This is just a slugfest.
Catinas.
Oh, Mo counter right hand.
Catinas in that corner is yelling out for him just to keep jabbing and low kick.
What a performance from Catinas, a man who's only had three K1 fights. He's only 22 years old. His first time ever in the final 16, and he's taking the best shots of Mighty Mo. Catinas is wobbled. The legs aren't there. But has Mo got the guts? Has he got the fuel to follow through? Liver shot, and Mo takes one to the John Smalls. Josh Barnett damaged those enough. I think they're impervious to pain by this stage. Good leg kick again from Catinas. He's scoring in this round.
Well, he's going back to what he's supposed to do. Stick and move, stick and move.
Yeah, Catinas is back to his original game plan, and it's starting to wear off on Mo.
Mo dipping away, lowering the boom. Overhand right, left hook from Catinas. Oh, he tags him with a left hook and then gets answered. Two shots from Mo. How is Raul Catinas standing? They breed them tough in Bucharest.
A knee from Mo.
I think going back to Eddie Mills, he's actually done wonders for Mo.
Just 12 hours on the plane. Imagine if they actually trained.
I think he actually trained on the way here.
Yeah, on a plane.
He was doing push-ups in the aisle on the flight over from LAX. Big uppercut, almost took out a low-flying aircraft. Final seconds of the round. What a crazy fight. Catinas comes forward and cracks the leg. My word, one more round remaining. Brother Ray, how do you see it?
I think I'll give it to Catinas.
It could be a 10-all round for this
one. It's possible, but I think Catinas, Mo rocked him in a couple of, early in the first round, but I think it may go to, a draw.
Two judges gave it a 10-all, one judge gave it 10-9. So Mo is still ahead. And if Mo can just keep the momentum going here in the third round, even at this pace, with this performance, he'll win the fight because he's got a 10-8 advantage from the first round.
Exactly.
Mighty Mo got the 10-9 on one judge's scorecard. Mighty Mo still leads after two. But Raul Catinas, the 22-year-old, in the final 16 for the first time, he shows he is not done yet. He shows no respect for Mo. And Mighty Mo takes a deep breath. Here we go, third and final round. Body shot from Catinas. Mo lunges out with a right hand. Leg kick from Mo. Overhand right from Mo.
Hey, this is the best Mo look, and this is without training in a long time.
Well,
in a long time.
Yes.
He may not get the mighty back, but he's definitely on the way.
Left hand from Mo, body shot from Catinas. Mo is looking for his second appearance in the K1 Grand Prix.
Catinas is fighting his whole fight wrong, even this last round.
But he's hanging in there, boy, he's tired.
Well, Mo is doing such a great job. The fact that he took the fight such late notice, but he's still there. And Catinas, you know, he knows Mo is dangerous, so he shouldn't be there. He should be sticking and moving.
Hey, Catinas could be jabbing and leg kicking this whole round and probably put Mo away for the leg shots, but once a slugger, you're always a slugger. You can't take it away from him. That's his style. That's what he does.
Going to the body again. And they spill.
That's
to
a
the
great
canvas.
Takedown.
And they switch to MMA right away. Mo puts him inside the guard and goes for the arm lock. I didn't have
it. The man thought he was going to go for an armbar.
What more have they got left, these two warriors?
Ooh, a face jab.
Mighty Mo. All clinched up.
Single confetti flying solo.
He turns 37. In just a week's time, Mighty Mo. Oh, right hand! And Catinas answers with a knee to the midsection. Belly button through the back.
Is that the 20th time that Mo's turned 37? Or?
That's the official age, though.
Mo is past 37, baby.
Rumor would be he's about 3 years older, right?
Mo is like 47.
I never believe rumors.
Oh, happy 29th, Ray. When's that coming up?
Yeah, I'm turning 21, matter of fact, tomorrow.
Catinas getting a warning here for double clinching.
Catinas is breathing heavy.
And Mo got the much-needed rest. Well, they both got much-needed rest.
Nice knee there from Catinas. He has never been in a war like this. Mo goes wild, firing the uppercuts. 33 seconds remain. You wonder what could have been had Mo had a full 8 weeks to train.
Very impressive from Mo.
Left hook from Mo. Left hook from Catinas. He gets caught again, the Romanian. Can Mo drop him? Overhand right from the American. Catinas is spent. He's got nothing left. Mo trying to drop him, but Raul just won't go down.
Beautiful. I think Mo was taking it for sure.
I believe so, right?
I think Mo's taking his fight.
Oh, absolutely.
Mighty Mo is going to get another berth in the Grand Prix. He hasn't been there for many, many a year. He is always the go-to guy. And this time, the go-to has paid off with a newfound resolve, a newfound physique, some newfound techniques.
Hey, that was a good performance from Mo. Day before yesterday, this guy was uncertain what's going to happen. Well, 3 days ago. Then he got on the plane. I'm just shocked he went through the three rounds.
Good, my hat off to him if I was wearing one.
He has done it. Mighty Mo is through. He joins Peter Ortiz, Kyotaro, Daniel Gita, Gokhan Sagi, and Tyrone Spong. Yes, America. You've got a representative in the K1 Grand Prix.
That's awesome.
All the fans watching across North America and HDNet will be loving that. The Star Spangled Banner, Old Glory, will be flying at the Yokohama Arena on December 11. The Romanian flag will be flying as well, but it'll be flown by Daniel Keita.
Mike.
But that is a career-making fight there for Raul Catinas, Ray.
Oh,
because
sure.
He's shown, fighting outside of Romania, on the biggest stage of all, he's the real deal.
Absolutely. I mean, this fight, can be correct me if I'm wrong, this fight is a reserve match fight, right?
No, this final 16.
Final 16.
Awesome.
Mo's going to the final eight.
Mo is in the final eight.
That's awesome.
As strange as that may sound, Mighty Mo's going to the final eight, baby.
Mo, who replaced Andrei Arlovski. We hear various rumors about Arlovski, but I've got to say, after seeing Catinas here tonight, it's wise that Arlovski wasn't in this final.
Yeah, if he didn't break his nose in training, he would have broken it here for sure.
Yeah, okay.
Broken nose would have been the least of his problems, the way Catinas was firing tonight.